Hello everyone, my name is Akshay Gaikwad. So I'll be delivering a talk on Python super function. So it's a built-in function. So it has a lot of utility, a lot of functionality of the super function. But in this lightning talk, I will try to cover only the introduction and the mechanism part. And I'll suggest few advice on the uses of super function. A bit about myself. I am a Python developer. I also work as a volunteer in Python Pune meetup group. In my free time, I write a post at akshayg.in, and I am on Twitter with handle akshayg196 with A and G capital. So let's begin. So the today's agenda of this talk. So I will try to explain terminology because I have seen that like in super when I read articles when I discuss with the people I see there are some terminologies which are used in super which are the basic terminologies used in Python. And so it would be good if you know the terminology clear before we know the super and we start this talk. And then we will have a super we will discuss what is super, its definition, and is technical term super and the function, what it does. We'll talk about history, what we do, how we write a code before super was introduced. I'll talk about the benefit, what is MRO. This is something new, you probably don't know about it, but it's a underneath mechanism of the super function. And I just have a few advice taken from the internet and from the people who use super in the projects. So it's advice on usage of super function. So similar to me, many times we just use super any built-in function, but we don't know its functionality and its mechanism. That's why we don't know how we can use it fully or completely. So it really useful to know how this function work underneath. So let's begin with the terminologies. These are the few terminologies I want to share with you. It's like the object, class, and the second is class. So I just cover up in a couple of minutes here only. So object is the grouping of data and method together. So let's say like a person is object with the attribute name and the address. And a few methods. So it's such a group of data and methods altogether. So class defines how we make an object. So let's say let's take an example of square. If I write a class with the name square, and if I write s is equal to square opening and close bracket. So this is the instantiation the class, and it returns the object. So hope object and class is clear. Two more terminologies is superclass and subclass. So superclass is like parent, and subclass is like a child of that class. So if you are belong from the object oriented paradigm, you probably know the inheritance and the super. Actually, it's a inheritance means it has a base class, and we write another class which has the functionality of the base class. So its main usage is to enhance the functionality of the class, and just to avoid the rewriting code and the save bit of lines. Hope this is clear. And I actually talk about the inheritance as well. So single inheritance and multiple inheritance is important if you want to understand the super function. So multiple inheritance means for the subclass we have multiple superclasses. So it's like multiple parents to a to a class. I hope this is clear. I just have one example here, which I just mentioned. As I, in the first line, I just write a class square. And just I just don't do anything in this class, so I just write a pass, so it's a definition of class only and does nothing. And in the second line, I just instantiate the class, it returns the object yes. And if you know about the magic functions, the attributes that are there in the object, you probably run like yes.dunder class dunder. You will return the class name of that object. And here is the class name is square. It's a class, class object basically. And if you do dot on the same class, if you do dot dunder base and dunder, it will return its base class. So all the classes in Python are inherited from the object. So it will return the object class. Hope this is clear to everyone. Okay, next. So what is super? So I just add a screenshot of Python official documentation, and it says that it will return super, return proxy object that delegate method calls to a parent or a sibling class of type, right? So it's a technical definition in layman terms. Simply, we can say that super gives you the access to the methods in the super class from the subclass that inherit from it. So one more interesting thing term here is the proxy object. So here super does not return the actual super class. It's object. It's a proxy object to super class. So it's a temporary object basically of the superclass. So use case of superclass, use case of super is when we build the classes, we may extend the functionality of the already previous built classes. So let's say in this, let's take an example here. Okay, so I just written a class rectangle. Which has the init, which is the constructor, which takes the input as the length and width. As we all know, the rectangle needs a length and width. It has the rectangle class has the methods called area and perimeter. So area is the calculation of area with the help of length and width, and perimeter, as we all know. So I just write another class which is square. So in case of square, let's look at the second part here only. In the square, it's in the init function. Init function, we take the length because all we know the square has only length because all the sides of square are equal. So it's again, it's calculate the area and the perimeter. So the interesting fact here is square is a special kind of rectangle. With special, I mean it has only one length, where it has length and width are the same. So we can only pass the single parameter, which is length. So here in this case, we can rewrite the square class, which is as mentioned in the third part, such as it just inherit from the rectangle. So I said super is a special kind of rectangle. So in the third part, I just input the length and I call a super. Okay, so here actually it calls the rectangle, which is the base class of the super square. And I call the init of the rectangle and pass the length two times, which is the length and width for the rectangle. I hope this is clear. So super take two arguments, but I didn't add an example for the argument super with the arguments. So So it takes the argument with the you can pass the subclass type and the object to the super function. Next one is what we before the super was introduced, we actually need to write the code as mentioned, as displayed on the screen. We need to call the rectangle with the init function. So here super gives a functionality which is indirect references. That means we don't need to keep track of all the base class and its base class. We just need to call the super and we are okay with all the thing. So there are bit of benefit of indirect references that is used by super. So we can isolate the change. So let's say if I edit the source code to switch the base class name to the some another mapping. So in that case, the super references will automatically follow. So we don't need to change everything. We just need to change. We don't need to change anything if we change the base class name. So we actually isolate the change. Another benefit of the indirect references is we can if you are coming from the static programming background, this is something which you don't know, because indirect references is computed at runtime, so that we have the freedom to influence the computation, so that the indirection will point to the other class in any time. And there are a lot of other benefits of using super. Okay, so another thing is method resolution order, which is also known as MRO. So how the super works? Python keeps the track of all the base classes and its base classes until we reach to the object, which is the root class of all the classes. So here, let's say a square that we define, we call square dot dunder MRO dunder. We actually see the C1 tuple. So here, the square is actually a class. Its parent is rectangle. Its parent is object class. So here, let's say if you call super dot method in the square class, so it actually look for that method in the rectangle, and if it not there in the rectangle, it actually look for the same method in its parent classes, which is object. So this is how it works. So method resolution order is how we search for the inherited methods. So this is basically ancestor tree or the search order. So as I said, it's a sequence of classes and its base class and its base class until it reaches object. And this process of solving this constraint is called linearization. There are two points which are important in this constraint, which is children precede their parent. So here, the square comes first before the rectangle. So children class always precede their parent. And if you have used super in multiple inheritance, we need to understand that the order of appearance in bases, like how we call the base classes in the inheritance, is respected. Like if you let's say square is inherited from rectangle and triangle class. Let's take an example. It's not actually a real world example, but let's say square is inherited from rectangle and triangle. So if you call squared super dot area, area is one of the method. So then how super actually works here, like how it search for the area. So basically it will search for the first class which is inherited, let's say it is a rectangle. If the area is not there in the rectangle, it will go for the another class which is triangle, and this is how it works. So order of appearance, order of the how we write page classes is important here. So to work the reordering of the classes properly, a class need to be designed cooperatively. So like I said, it's very important to know how we inherited the classes and how the sequence of the inheritance. Okay, next point is like the advice about uses of super. The first is method being called by super need to be exist. Let's say if you're calling any method and if it's not exist, it will throw an error. Or if it's not exist in the entire tree or ancestor tree of the class or the in MRO, it will throw an error. So it's always better to write a root class which has the method which you want to derive later or inherit later. If you are saying that all the exceptions that are inherited from the base exception class, so this is how the exception works. Like base exception has all the things which are required for the exception, and all the exceptions that we create are derived from the base exceptions. Yep. The second thing is matching the argument pattern. So the caller and callee of the super classes, super function, need to have the matching argument signature. So you can use the positional arguments here, or you can use the keyword arguments or the keyword argument dictionary, so that it will always have the matching patterns. And the last advice, which is the occurrence of method need to use super. So it's a chain of classes. So it should not be broken thing. So the chain of delegation continues unbroken. So that's a bit of advice you can use when you design a software in Python. So that's all I have. Here are the few references. You can use the official documentation of Super. There is two more blogs post regarding the Super. And Real Python has very good introduction about the Super function. That's all I have today. Yep, thank you.